If you wanted to define this program, so I can tell you, on one level, it's you can look at it as prescription, right? It's constantly varied functional movements executed at high intensity. Or you can talk to the adaptation and say that what I did in my second lecture here, just regurgitate that it's about increasing work capacity across broad time and modal domains. Well, it's also about working with some funky movements. I mean, in the most macro kind of sense, people will identify this program looking outside the gym, looking in. Because they're over there doing this shit, right, at Globo Gym, and they look in here, and look, there's like nets in the roof and shit. Yeah, they actually like climb. What is it that we're doing that is so different? It is that we have deliberately engaged in movements that require some technique, and I'm here to talk to you about why. The why of that. Is it because I got a lot of time on my hands, and I was a gymnast, and I like cute little movements in slippers with your toes pointed? Is that it?
Yeah.
You weren't supposed to tell them. No, it's because the payoff is worth it. The payoff is worth it. Now, look, we deliberately flens coordination, accuracy, agility, and balance, and I'm not talking about removing the gymnastics components, even though I keep hearing that guys 6 feet tall, 200 pounds, can't do gymnastics. I introduce them to Eddie Lugo. They're like, oh, shit, okay, let me come up with another excuse. And by the way, the dangerous is just a wild red herring, entirely unsubstantiable. Not unsubstantiated, unsubstantiable. There are reasons for engaging in these movements that have nothing to do with anything other than safety. If I can justify the inclusion of the movements we include for safety alone. So we flens balance, agility, accuracy, coordination, and immediately power and speed take a hit. Why?
Yeah,
they're built from it, yes. They're half neurological, at least.